In this session, let's take a look at a marketing checklist we put together for your construction business. You can use this when considering marketing programs for your home building business. Remember, marketing is about developing a positive perception in the subconscious mind of the prospect before the buying decision is made. The prospect wants to know that your business is worthy of her consideration. The goal of a marketing program is to place your company front of mind when the prospective client thinks about building a home. It is just as important to avoid a negative impression as it is to build a positive impression. That is why you want your marketing package, including your appearance, your quote, your sales presentation, and even your vehicle, to be professional, logical, and tidy. When you are in front of your prospect, you must exude competence and capability. Buying a house is a huge financial decision and commitment, and your prospect must feel that you appreciate the difficulty of the decision she is making. Tell the prospect that you understand how careful they must be, and you intend to give them all the information they need to make an intelligent decision, and that you hope the decision will lead to working together to build the house they want. The first category we want to deal with is your image. And the first thing under your image is your business name. You want to make sure that it's easy to pronounce, that it's unique, that there are no negative associations to it, like satanic structures or black hole builders. You want to pay attention, number two, to positioning. Don't confuse your prospect. You can't be all things to all people, so don't even try. Spend time refining and defining your niche, and then work that niche with your advertising. Number three is colors. Choose a color that will be your color. Work it into all promotions. Bright colors are used for young people. Muted, richer colors for older people. Customers unconsciously respond to your use of color, but they respond in a big way. Number four is your logo. Simple shapes are recognized most quickly and actually go deeper into the mind for better retention. Studies show that ovals are best and simple is best. Number five is your unique value proposition. No more than seven words that say what you're about. The best is 3 to 4 words with an emotional appeal to them. Leave the meaning a little fuzzy. Here are some propositions from past advertising that we've seen. Quality is job one. You're in good hands. The real thing. We work. We cover the world. From chaos to control. With your unique value proposition, you're going to be using emotionally loaded words to make sure that people understand the kind of services that you offer. Number six is your reputation. This gives your prospects a conscious validation of the unconscious decision made on the basis of your image package. A good reputation will not necessarily be the deciding factor in a purchase decision, but a bad reputation will definitely work against you. Number seven is your story. People respond to a story. What is it you do that nobody else does? What have you done that nobody else will do? Where did you come from? What sets you apart? Why should I remember you? Number eight is your website. In this day and age, it's an absolute must-have. It's an electronic brochure. Use it as a billboard on the information highway. Most people use the internet to check on vendors prior to a purchase, especially a large purchase. If you're not here, it says negative things about your business. You're too small, you're not keeping up with new developments, you're too cheap, and so on. This is an absolutely critical must-have in this day and age for advertising. Number nine, a column in a publication. Ask if your local newspaper would like a column on some aspect of home ownership. You're the pro, so give them what they need. Number 10, testimonials. Ask happy customers to write letters and then frame the letters and put them on display. Include them in your promotional literature. Post them on your website. No marketing piece is stronger than a good testimonial. Number 11, word of mouth. To get word of mouth, your business must be front of mind. You get there with a well-designed image package, superb service, and referrals. Number 12, website and social marketing. Use these to establish your expertise. Use it as an electronic brochure. Studies show that appealing to the eye and the ear is 68% more effective than either one of these alone. add a YouTube video explaining why you use the floor system or the plumbing fixtures that you use. Have a subcontractor talk about why he enjoys working with you and about the products or techniques used in his phase. Number 13, a newsletter. Be the consultant and be helpful. The letter is not about you. It is about how you are addressing the needs of your market niche. Each letter is self-contained and addresses one part of the home building process. Distribute this newsletter on a regular schedule. Post it on your website and archive past issues there so they can be accessed. The second major category is your presentation. Number 14, words mean something. When you're talking with your customers, use the words they want to hear. Value, long-lasting, unique, safety, comfort. Depending on what your market research tells you they want to talk about, develop a list of words that are important to your prospects and then make sure you and your sales force use those words in conversations. Number 15, consultations. Offer free, non-binding consultation to prospects planning their own home. Help you design to keep costs down, to increase your energy efficiency, to enable you to age in place. Whatever statement rings the bell for your market niche. Number 16, your sales presentations. Learn to use effective and emotionally loaded phrases. I'll take care of it. I know just what you mean. Let me repeat that to make sure I'm understanding you. These can all be especially effective as you work with new customers. Number 17, sales training. All employees and subcontractors need to know how you expect the customer or prospect to be treated. Don't assume your framer or roofer will be nice. Tell him how to talk to your prospect, or tell him not to talk to them at all. Number 18, business cards and stationery. Your business card is a mini brochure for your company. You aren't a snooty attorney. Stationery should be of appropriate quality and tone. Number 19, brochures, 8.5 by 11, trifold. The story of the company, pictures with large typeface. Just to leave something with her after your meeting. Color printers and word processors make these so easy to produce, there's no reason for not having them. Number 20, the yellow pages. This used to be where people looked first, but it has been supplanted by the web. However, it's still important to show stability. No reason for a large expenditure here. You may find that a small ad referring the prospect to your website is the most effective tack to take. Number 21, television and radio commercials. These are always expensive, but can be very rewarding if you hit your market niche. Using this channel requires lots of study of demographics. Don't use it unless you are also prepared to commit to a backup plan, including mailings, handouts, website tie-ins, and so on, before, during, and after the commercial campaign. This is a very powerful way for establishing your position in the market, but as I said, it's pretty expensive as well. Number 22, tie-in with other merchants. You display their stuff, they display yours. Talk to furniture stores, shed manufacturers, garage storage companies. They may all be interested in helping you market your houses better by using their products. Number 23, reprints of ads and other publicity. Make reprints of newspaper ads or columns you've written to be distributed. Put them on your website. Remember, you're the pro. Number 24, suppliers' ads. Ask suppliers for their brochures and distribute them to your prospects. Let the prospects know, this is the kind of quality we are going to use in building your house. Number 25, supplier links. Put links to your suppliers on your website. Make it easy for the prospect to find out more about the products you use. Some suppliers will reciprocate by listing you on their site. Ask them. Number 26, magazine ads. Look at local or regional magazines. If there are ads for the products you use, copy the ad and use it as a mailer or an email. You can say, as seen in, to provide special credibility for your efforts. The third category is your product. Number 27, convenience. Make it easy for your prospect to get a bid, to work with their lender, to place the order, and to complete all the myriad steps required. Number 28. Speed. Delivery speed at each step in the process indicates your level of interest in pleasing your prospect. Respond quickly to their request for a quote. Have a schedule and stick to it for building the house. Get back to her quickly regarding change orders. That shows you care. Number 29. Pricing. Studies indicate that only 14% of prospects say price is important. Pricing is probably even more important for the builder because of lender appraisal and lending guidelines. Know and build what your market niche can afford. Number 30. Availability of financing. Customers want the whole package. You'll sell more homes if you have a relationship with a bank or mortgage company, which allows you to do the sale and the financing in one stop. Number 31. Follow-up. Consistent, but not overbearing, follow-up lets the prospects know you are interested in building their homes. Don't let them fall through the gaps. Number 32. Public displays. Billboards, bus benches, taxicabs, coffee cups, caps, shirts, measuring tapes, balloons at public events, and so on. The more offbeat and attention-getting, the better in this category. Just try not to get silly and put your company in the wrong light. Number 33. Take one boxes. Place in locations such as restaurants, grocery and convenience stores, donut shops, frequented by prospects. Absolutely have a take one box at your current job sites, showing the floor plan and elevation of the house you are building and indicating your interest in doing the same for any prospect who is interested. Number 34. Outside signs. Put professionally produced signs at your job sites letting people know who is building this house. Also have a sign at your place of business, especially if you work out of your house, so prospects can find you easily. Number 35. Gift baskets. Include coupons from local merchants, especially your suppliers. Send to buyers within 7 days of their move-in date. A little extra perk for working with you. There you have it, 35 suggestions for putting your marketing program in place. I'm sure you can think of a dozen more or several dozen more, but the main thing is to think about it. Put a program in place and start moving forward with identifying your market niche, giving that market niche what they are looking for, and making more sales. You'll find the checklist for these suggestions on the Builder Resources website at www.builder-resources.com, and there's much more available there as well in marketing, business operation, and a number of other ideas and topics for running your construction business.